All right, we are in the Road Show kitchen this morning. Chef Paul Shire's here. He's one of our friends. He's been here a bunch of times. And to Pauls City Grille, you got a lot of things today. We're going to make shrimp Mozambique.
Yes, sir.
That's on the menu today. It's good to have you here today.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
All right. You're going to cook this up for us today. This is pretty simple, and you don't have too many ingredients that we actually need to, you know, to get to put together. So let's go over the ingredients. So if someone wants to make it tonight, they can do it.
Sure. I have a shrimp peeled, deveined, left the tail on, a little bit of extra virgin olive oil, blended oil to start it out in.
Right.
Salt and pepper. The hot sauce, which is the main ingredient
all
for
right,
this.
What kind of hot sauce are we using? Is this
the Frank's and the Tabasco. It's a kind of a blend.
All right. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
A little bit of ground saffron. Sliced garlic. Butter. Lemon juice. Beer.
Okay.
Which is always good. And a fish stock.
Okay. And then will we use this pan and then we get another pan over here for it?
I'm just going to use this one probably today. I wasn't
okay.
sure.
All right. How are you going to do that? Okay. And we've got the shrimp itself. About how much shrimp are we going to need for this, or it depends on how many people you're going
to... I do it as an appetizer at the restaurant. So you usually get 8 to 12 shrimp and
right.
some crusty garlic bread that goes with it to dunk, because you've got to dunk the sauce after you prepare it.
Okay. What kind of bread? Because if you're going to make garlic bread, you need the right bread to hold it together. You want it to have some sort of crispiness on the outside. What do
Absolutely.
You got?
I got a nice crunchy Italian bread, nice crusty outside, and we blend some butter and herbs, a little bit of grated cheese, and that's it. Toast it up in the convection oven.
Right, okay. And how long is it going to take in the convection? Because it's probably not going to take
4 minutes. While I'm cooking this, 4 or 5 minutes at 400, 450, you're done.
And you're done. And even this recipe here, even cooking this and putting this together, this is pretty simple, too.
Very simple.
It doesn't take much time either.
Not much at all.
Okay, good. All right, we've got that going on. And with a beautiful day like today, this is what you can make tonight out on in the house or out on the deck tonight. You can whip this up pretty quick. Back to you.
Now, let's send it back over to Will in the kitchen.
Thanks, Brendan. That is a great video on this Monday morning. We are here with Paul Shire from Two Pauls. We're making shrimp Mozambique today. And this guy over here, before he actually gets cooking, he's going to give us a little history lesson on the recipe itself, right?
Well, shrimp Mozambique. Mozambique is in the southeast part of Africa, right across from Madagascar. 15th century Portuguese explorers actually found natives using hot peppers to make spicy sauces.
Okay.
They really liked this, and they adapted it to make it their own.
And that's where some of the hot sauce and all this other stuff.
The hot sauce is the main thing that they got from the natives.
And that's part of it. Okay, so we have some hot sauce, and you actually mix two blends. You mix the Tabasco and the Frank's Red Hot.
Yes.
Kind of blended it together for a unique flavor.
And it's mild compared to some of them.
Some of them, okay.
Yeah.
All right, so we got the hot pan, you've got the shrimp, so if you want to toss some of these on, and you've got your garlic bread, too.
And this is so quick that you can start the garlic bread actually right when you're making the shrimp.
Okay.
Pop that right in.
Yep.
Get the pan nice and hot.
Put that in, let this, and what kind of oil did you...
That's a blended oil,
okay.
And then because I'll pour a lot of that off, and I'll finish with the extra virgin olive oil and the butter when I use it.
All right,
we'll get these going. A little salt and pepper on these.
Okay. A shrimp, pretty easy to cook. You kind of know when they are completely done.
They cook really fast.
We'll put those in there. And then as far as if you don't like the things too hot, obviously you can blend things together, and you also have... So what is this powder here?
That's a little bit of saffron, ground saffron.
Okay.
Which makes a nice flavor for it, too.
And how long will these have to go?
I'd say a minute or two on each side. Then I add all the ingredients. It makes a great appetizer. You get a little extra sauce. You can soak the garlic bread in there.
Right. And then you also have you've got the garlic bread in the oven, and you have, what kind of bread were we using for that?
Nice crusty Italian bread.
Crusty Italian bread.
We can also, the good part, you can also put this over rice or pasta. A lot of people at the restaurant will come in and say, can I have a side of rice, and they'll pour it right over
and
the top.
And they'll put it right in.
Make a dinner out of it.
Blend
it
all together. It doesn't just have to be an appetizer. We'll put the rest of it together. Talk about the restaurant itself coming up in just a little bit. Back to you. We're in the Roadshow kitchen this morning. Chef Paul Shire is here from Two Pauls City Grille. He's got shrimp Mozambique on the menu. He gave us a little history lesson about shrimp Mozambique last segment. Now he's all ready to go.
Yeah, let's put
I'm not
going to
start throwing stuff around like the bartenders. I get a little skeptical because sometimes you see a bottle of Absolute go up and then you get pop off in the glass. So. Anyways, can you give me those tongs, please?
Absolutely. Awesome. So we're going to get those shrimp going there. Did you prep the shrimp at all? Give them a little seasoning or anything?
Salt and pepper before they went in the pan.
Keep it simple.
Just brown them a little bit. You're almost ready to flip over, and then we'll add the garlic.
So is this a special
appetizer? This is an appetizer,
or...
we do.
Oh, and, it's an app. Great.
Every night we have 4 to 6 half-price appetizers, too.
Right.
So you can come in and get this for half price.
We love that. From 4 to 6 every night?
Every night.
Beautiful.
We do it every night.
And you said some people also like to put this over pasta. They'll get
make
rice
a dinner
with it,
right
make
out it, of
and
it.
Make a dinner out of it. So it doesn't just have to be the appetizer.
I'm going to add the garlic now.
Okay.
We'll brown that up a little.
Okay.
Let me slice
so a
garlic.
A couple different options there. And shrimp is fairly quick. I like shrimp along with some other seafoods where you can physically see it cooking. You know, there's really
right.
no question about it.
you have
know
to put
when
a thermometer in there or anything. So maybe when it gets to about that point when the garlic, it's a little tiny bit more
okay.
going to get sweet. And then we're going to add the beer.
And what type of beer are you putting in? Just anything that you kind of like?
That's Sam Adams,
this
I
is
think.
Sam Adams,
yeah.
okay. All right.
But you can put whatever you
whatever
want.
Whatever you want
in
it.
It.
All right.
All right.
Is there any beer that you should stay away from? Are you using, you know, light beer rather than dark beer or lager?
I like the lager beer.
Okay.
I think it gives it a better flavor.
It has a richer flavor to it.
Definitely. So,
that's a good tip.
So there was the beer.
Okay.
I thought it reduced a little, and then we have the little fish stock, or clam juice if you don't
mm-hmm.
have fish stock.
Mm-hmm. Nice.
And this is a little bit of powdered saffron.
I like that you're giving our viewers a lot of different options. You know,
yes.
if you don't have one, use another. If you
and
want to
hot sauce.
This is the key, right?
Yes, the hot sauce. And if you have your favorite hot sauce, use that one.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to use the Frank's or the Tabasco.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to put a little... I have some lemons already squeezed right here.
Yum.
A little lemon juice in there.
Love lemon with seafood.
I'm going to reduce a tiny bit, and then we just put the butter in, and we're good.
All right, so as that reduces, tell us what else is going on at Two Pauls. You said, gosh, there's always something each night, in addition
Definitely.
To the half-price apps.
We have, every night, we have 10 items from $10 on the weekdays.
Wow.
So you can come in. It's nice stuff. We have,
sure, yeah.
You know, meatloaf, some of our main staples are on there.
Mm-hmm.
Weekends, we have jazz every once a month on Saturday nights. We have live music every Saturday,
mm-hmm.
karaoke on Fridays, the Burger Blitz on Wednesdays, $5 prime burgers.
That's great. Mean,
wow. Yeah, so you can come in and get a nice big burger, 8-ounce burger.
Wow, for $5.
For $5.
For $5, that's,
yeah.
that's fantastic.
Yeah.
And take a look at their menu, too. I mean, it is so extensive. Like you said, there's everything from those staples, the meatloaf, and then you've got a dish like this. What else is on
Fresh
the menu?
Fresh salmon, we get in every day. You have swordfish, steak.
You even have a kid's menu, too.
We have a kid's
right
menu,
here.
Yep, and they can color my face if they want.
Right Draw some glasses or
and,
something.
And
funny.
Where are you guys located to?
It's 315 Waterman Ave.
Okay.
And it was used to be Joseph's years ago. He
mm-hmm.
did very
yes,
well there.
Yes,
and that's
I remember that. Yeah.
So that's pretty much done on that.
And you've added some butter to that, and then we're going to serve it up with some nice homemade garlic bread.
Yes.
We love that.
That garlic bread alone looks fantastic.
Mm-hmm. We'll have to try that out for sure. If you want this recipe so you can make it for dinner tonight, head on over to the Rhode Show page, WPRI.com.